SharePoint, clunky, boring, and stuck in 2008. That's what goes through a lot of people's mind when they think about the word SharePoint. And to be honest, before my time at skybow, I felt the same way. But then I built a solution, a SharePoint solution that feels like modern software. If you're also one of the skeptics, let me prove you wrong. In this video, I'm going to show you what happens if good UX meets SharePoint. The main goal of the social media post planner is to make the social media post planning process way easier and to include more people of the company into the social media post planning process. For that, every user who has access to the social media post planner can submit topics for social media posts. We will now have a look at all the features and functionalities you need for that in the SharePoint app. At first, we have an easy dashboard which provides an overview of all the posts which need to be approved, the scheduled posts, and for the scheduled posts, we also have a calendar view which gives you an excellent overview of all the posts which are planned in the following weeks. If you want to look at the status, you can also look at the list view. As I mentioned in the beginning of the video, for every user who has access to the social media post planner, it's possible to submit topics for social media posts. To do so, we placed a new form. In this new form, users can provide all the information which are needed to decide if the topic should be posted on social media or not. Once users provided all the information needed, they can submit the topic. In the social media post planning process, there is one edge case. Sometimes you have urgent topics which need to be posted immediately or within the following days. For that, we have another new form, which is for submitting urgent topics. Here, users need to provide the same information as in the form before, plus extra information, because such posts overgo a few of the process steps of the approval process to be posted in time. So users also need to provide the posting day, say why the topic couldn't be placed earlier, write the final posting text, and provide all the media which should be posted with the social media post. Once everything is ready, you can submit the time-sensitive post. Then the admin team will get notified via Teams message or email that there is an urgent topic which needs their attention. Let's now go back to the normal approval process of the social media post planner. Every once in a while, so maybe once a month or twice a month, the social media post planning team can get together and make the posting plan for the next period. To do so, go to Create Post Schedule. Here we provided a SharePoint page with everything they need to know to create the post schedule for the next period. We have the scheduled topics and, more important, the topic backlog, where all the submitted topics go. As you can see, you can also see the topic we just submitted. Here you now have an overview of the whole approval process. We can see all the information about the topic, and if we decide to post the topic within the next period, we can schedule it. To do so, we need to choose a posting day, the person in charge to write the post, and we can provide notes, what to include in the post, and ideas for media, so the person in charge knows what to do. Notes and ideas for media are not necessary. Let's schedule the topic. As soon as we did so, the person in charge gets notified via email or Teams message. Our social media topic can now be found under Schedule Posts, and the final post can be written by the person in charge. To do so, just go to the creation form. Here, we can have a look at the notes that the social media planning team left and can write the final post and provide all the media which is needed to publish the post. If you aren't finally ready yet, you can save it as draft and edit it later on. But if you're happy with your post and all the media is provided, you can send it for approval. Then again, the admins will get notified via Teams message or email that there is a post to be approved. If you're an admin, you will see both posts we just submitted in the post to be approved area. So there is the urgent topic and the normal post. Let's open it. Here we can have a look at the post text and review all the media. If everything's all right, we can start the approval. Here we have the chance to approve or reject the post. If we would reject the post, we would need to provide a reason and notes for the person in charge what they need to edit. We will approve the post. Then the person in charge again gets notified that everything is okay. Let's also have a look at the urgent topic. Here you can at first see that the post tracker is a bit different. It's an urgent topic and will then directly go to approved if we approve the post. So it will overgo a few of the steps. Here we can also start the approval. Have a look at the posting text and all the provided media, and then again have the chance to approve or reject the post. If we approve it or reject it, the person in charge will get notified via email or Teams message. As you can see, both of our posts are now scheduled and approved, the urgent topic as well as the normal post. If you now want to publish the post, just open it and go to the publishing form. There is no functionality that the post is published on the social media platform automatically. You have to do that manually. So just copy the text, download the media, and upload it to the desired social media platform. If you would post it automatically, that would harm your visibility. So we would always recommend doing it manually because that boosts your visibility on the social media platform. If the post is published, mark it as published. Afterwards, you can find all the published posts in the posting archive. This is a SharePoint page which summarizes all the published posts, which could be an inspiration for new ones. So if you once don't know what to post next, have a look at older posts. Maybe you will get inspired. The last point on the homepage, which is still missing, is the admin page. Here, we created a SharePoint page which provides all the functionalities and information an app admin needs. This way, also non-SharePoint experts can be app admin. At first, we have the possibility to delete all the demo data. When you open the app first, you have the possibility to create demo data. If you want to use the app productively, you can delete all the demo data with just one click. Secondly, you can add new users. So you can add admins and normal team members. You also have a description what those user groups are allowed to do. As you can see, the Social Media Post Planner provides all the functionalities you need to make your social media post planning process way easier and to include all different areas of your company in the social media process and give them the possibility to place topics on your social media profiles. This, for example, is the email an app admin gets if an urgent topic was submitted. So they get the information that they need to review the post, and when clicking here, they immediately get to the post. So the effort is as low as possible. Same is for the person in charge to write a new social media post. So they get the information that their topic was submitted for the next period and when they need to provide the final post. And last but not least, the information that the post was approved and is planned for the next social media period. Would you have thought that this is a SharePoint solution at first glance? And the best is you can download exactly that SharePoint solution as a ready-to-use app from our website. I'm going to link it in the description below. If you want to know how I built this SharePoint app and what's important for good SharePoint UX, jump to the next video. There I'm going to explain everything what's important for you. Thanks for watching. See you the next time. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel if you want to learn more about how to build smart SharePoint solutions.